Good morning and welcome to this meeting of the New York State Senate Committee on Housing, Construction, and Community Development. I'm Brian Kavanaugh, Chair of the Committee. I'm joined here by Senator Helming, who is our ranking member of this committee, and Senator May. And it's a busy morning here in Albany. There are many other meetings going on, but we do have voting sheets from other members of this committee, some of whom may be joining us in person, and we do, by virtue of those present and the voting sheets that have been submitted, have quorum. We're joined today by staff, Naomi Lazarus, our Housing Committee Clerk, Hal Chu, fresh up from the big city of New York, the Housing Committee Director, and Nairam Gasu, Bobby Barnett, and Jessica Keen of our central staff. We're getting to the end of February. Since our last meeting, had a very robust discussion of the housing budget in our joint hearing of this committee and the finance committee, and we're moving forward with that process. Today we have a whole series of bills on our agenda, many of them particularly related to the operation of various programs that are intended to ensure affordability of housing for people who are seniors on fixed incomes or low incomes and people with disabilities. So unless there are any other opening comments or remarks, questions, okay. Why don't we get to the bills and agenda? If the clerk could read the first bill, please.
S-429, Senate Sponsor Krueger, an act to amend the administrative code of the City of New York and the real property tax law in relation to notice regarding the rent increase exemption for low-income elderly persons and persons with disabilities programs.
And this is a bill we've reported before, and we are looking for a motion to report to finance. Any questions or discussion? Do I have a motion? Senator May with a motion to report. I will second the motion, and maybe some senator anxiously try to get into the room, perhaps to second this motion. We are joined by Senators Clear and Jackson.
Good morning, everyone.
Do I have any negative votes on this first bill on the agenda? I have Senator Helming to the bill without recommendation. The bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill F-547B, Senate Sponsor Orlin-Segal, an act to amend the real property tax law in relation to directing the Comptroller of the City of New York to conduct annual audits of compliance with the Affordable New York Housing Program.
And this, again, we'll be looking for a motion to report this bill to finance. This is a bill. We have a motion from Senator Helming. A second from Senator Clear was first, even though Jackson was louder. Do I have any negative votes? Go ahead and vote. Any votes advanced without recommendation? The bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-711, Senate Sponsor Clear, an act to amend the administrative code of the City of New York in relation to eligibility requirements for rent increase exemptions for persons with disabilities.
This bill, again, will be looking for a motion to report to finance. Do I have any questions or discussion? And we have the sponsor present here.
Move the bill.
Got a motion from Senator Jackson.
Second
by Senator Clear again, silently seconding her motion for her own bill. Do I have any negative votes? Do I have any votes against that recommendation? The bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-1218B, Senate Sponsor Comrie, an act to amend the executive law in relation to the appointment for agricultural representation on the State Fire Prevention and Building Code Council.
And we'll be looking for a motion to report this to the floor. Any questions or discussion?
Move.
I've got a motion from Senator Jackson, a second from Senator Helming. Any negative votes? Any votes advance without recommendation? The bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-1447A, Senate Sponsor Standards, an act to amend the private housing finance law in relation to subsidizing closing costs for low-income tenants who are purchasing a home.
And the printed agenda suggests we would be looking to report this to the floor, but we are going to ask for a motion to report this to finance. Any questions? Motion from Senator Clear.
Second.
Second from Senator Jackson. Any negative votes? Any votes to advance this bill without recommendation?
AWR
from Senator Helming. Bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill 1870A, Senate sponsored clear, an act to amend the public housing law in relation to allowing prospective tenants of rent-controlled or rent-stabilized housing accommodations to request the complete rent history of such housing accommodations.
We have many good ideas from Senator Clear on today's agenda. Any kind of discussion or comments?
Move to bail.
Okay, we got a motion to second. Second by Senator May this time. Any negative votes? I go one no vote from Senator Helming. The bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-2246, Senate sponsor White, an act to amend the executive law and the tax law in relation to enacting the Open Physician Entrance Act.
Again, this will be looking for a motion to report this bill to finance, as we have in the past. Any questions or discussion?
I do have a question. What is that? The Open Physician Entrance.
This is a bill that requires, if you are providing certain medical services, that you have at least one entrance door that opens
just
automatically
to
facilitate
that, yeah.
Access for people who might have
things.
Okay, Senator, I've got a motion from Senator Clinton. A second from Senator May. Any negative votes? Any votes to advance our recommendation?
I like that bill.
The bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-3233, Senate sponsor Hoyland Seagal, an act in relation to requiring the Division of Housing and Community Renewal to calculate the period of rent reduction due to the diminution of services from the date of actual diminution of the services.
And this is a bill that the Senate passed last year. We'll be looking for a motion to report the floor. Any questions or discussion?
Move the bill.
Got a motion from Senator Clear, a second from Senator Jackson. Senator May almost got one in there.
No, I had a question.
Oh, you have a question, forgive me.
How often does the justification of the bill, is it three times as long as the actual bill itself?
Is this a statistical question?
I'm just curious.
If the clerk could do some analysis of that in advance of the next meeting, we'll have an answer for you next time. So I do have a motion on the floor. Any negative votes?
Negative.
I have a negative from Senator Helming. Any votes to advance our recommendation? The bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-4644, Senate sponsor Kennedy, an act to amend the executive law in relation to standards for fire hydrant systems and providing for the repeal of certain provisions upon expiration thereof.
This is also a bill this committee has seen before and we passed in the Senate last year. Any questions or discussion?
What does this bill do?
This basically sets standards for fire hydrants.
The distance?
It's
no, it's for, sorry.
Sorry, go ahead.
It's for, exactly. I unfortunately had this happen in a barn next to my home. It requires that, I believe, the municipalities or whoever's in charge to test the fire hydrants to make sure that they're actually working.
Mm-hmm.
It's good.
Oh, yeah.
And having it
do that in New York City. You know,
they're supposed to do it and document it, and that's what this bill.
So it amends that this committee, most of the things we deal with are related to housing, but we have the codes. We have the various codes. Councils are also in the jurisdiction of the committee. So
that's about
that.
I was curious.
Yeah, was the community development part?
This is a bill on behalf of our colleague, Senator Kennedy, who this might be his last chance.
So this is requiring testing.
Right.
And they don't do that everywhere.
I think they're supposed to, but I can say from experience that, volunteer fire company shows up, goes sees the hydrant, doesn't work.
Okay.
I will say,
also, there are additional reporting requirements to report the testing.
That we tested it and it works.
Yes.
Of course.
And deliver it to the governor.
They build it.
Right.
And what's important about them doing that too is if they test it doesn't work, then they cover it. So
we know, move forward.
Hopefully it'll be corrected soon.
That too.
I do think the fire department in New York City does a fair
job
of doing this work.
And the DEP, which is
responsible for the water system, but there are obviously a lot of hydrants out there, a lot of firefighters, so we want to make sure that they have the tools they need to fight the fire.
Absolutely.
Could you move the bill?
I have a motion from Senator Jackson.
Second.
The second is not clear. This will be reporting to the floor. Any negative votes? Any votes to advance our recommendation? Bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-4967, Senate sponsor Jackson, an act to amend the administrative code of the City of New York in relation to surcharges for the installation or use of certain appliances and housing accommodations subject to rent.
This is also a bill that has passed the Senate before. We'll be looking for a motion to report at the floor. We do have the sponsor present. Any questions or discussion?
Move
Move the bill.
Got a motion by Senator Cleer, second by Senator May. Any negative votes? Any votes against our recommendation? AWR from Senator Hellman. Bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-5262, Senate sponsor Sanders, an act to amend the administrative code of the city of New York in relation to providing for retroactive benefit calculation for the senior citizens' rent increase exemption and disability rent increase.
This is also a bill the Senate has passed before last year. We'll do it for a motion to report the floor. Any questions or discussion?
Move the bill.
Got a motion from Senator Cleer.
Second.
Second from Senator Jackson. Any negative votes? Any votes to advance without recommendation? Bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-6383, Senate sponsor Parker, an act to amend the administrative code of the city of New York in relation to continuation of senior citizens' rent increase exemption benefits after a period of ineligibility due to a head of household's temporary increase in income.
This is also a bill that passed the Senate last year. I would look for a motion to report to the floor. Any questions or discussion?
Move the bill.
Got a motion, a tie from Senator Jackson, Senator Cleer that time. So we'll take a second from Senator May. Any negative votes? Any votes to advance without recommendation? The bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-6852, Senate sponsor Parker, an act to amend the administrative code of the city of New York and the Emergency Tenant Protection Act of 1974. In relation to inspection of major capital improvements for which rent increases are requested, and in relation to extending the provisions of the rent stabilization law.
This is also a bill that was reported to the floor last year, and we would refer a motion to report to the floor again this year. Any questions or discussion?
Move the bill.
Got a motion from Senator Jackson. Second from Senator Cleer. Any negative votes? I've got AWR from Senator Hellman. Any other AWR? Bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill S-7625, Senate sponsor Kavanaugh, an act to amend the administrative code of the city of New York, the Emergency Tenant Protection Act of 1974, and the Emergency Housing Rent Control Law in relation to prohibiting surcharges for the installation or use of dishwashers in housing accommodations subject to rent regulation.
And we'll be looking for a motion to report this to the floor. Also, any questions or discussion?
Move the bill.
I just had a question about how this relates to 4967 that we just passed through. That one was for surcharges for other appliances.
This one is a specific concern about dishwashers, which there's typically a small surcharge, and it has been widely shown that dishwashers often save water, and so we don't want to be discouraging tenants from installing them by the surcharge. So this would repeal that. Different versions of these bills have been moving in the Senate, and the Assembly hasn't picked them up. So I think we're effectively giving the Assembly a menu of a couple different things. One of Senator Jackson had an agreement.
One of them was air conditioners. As long as your air conditioner and you're paying the electric bill, and that, right, then they shouldn't be able to charge you $5 or $10 for each AC. Right. Some people have more than one AC in their homes. And so it's just, if it's your AC and you paid for it and you're paying for the electricity bill, then you should not have to be charged. And that was passed into law.
Great.
About a year and a half, 2 years ago.
Any further questions or discussion?
No. Okay, and your bill seems to be up for rent control tenants as well.
Right now, everything is more rent control than rent stabilization. Because of the laws we passed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Any further questions? I got a motion from Senator May.
Second.
Second from Senator Cleer. A little bit reluctant, but
No.
Do I have any negative votes? Anybody said that's our idea? Bill is. Okay, I have AWR from Senator Hellman. Bill is reported. Thank you all.